Here with champion New Zealand, or former New Zealand jockey, Michael Walker. Michael, welcome, and you're enjoying a pretty rich vein of form at the minute.
Yeah, cheers, mate. Yeah, things are going pretty well. Just working hard and seeing what happens.
You started young. I mean, you, I think, first started professionally riding at 15. That's pretty young. Did you have to get special sort of dispensation to be allowed to ride at that age?
In New Zealand, you can ride when you're 15. You just got to do a 3-month probation. So I did have to get special dispensation because I was under 15 and I wanted to ride the day I turned 15. So.
Was it a family background in horse racing, or was it just you rode horses from a very early age? What was the background there?
Not really, mate. My cousins and I just rode the old Brumbies out the back and bareback, and that's all we did, and went pig hunting with the horse, riding the horses bareback. And I had an uncle who I wasn't really close to. I didn't really know much of him. He was a jockey, he was an apprentice of Colin Gillings, and sort of went from there, really.
He was a frequent visitor to Australia many, many years ago, Colin Gillings. So was it always, you took the world by storm over in New Zealand, certainly. Was it always the long distance plan to end up riding in Australia?
Yeah, most definitely. I moved here 7 or 8 years ago, probably too early. I'd admit now, if I knew then what I know now, it would have been a different story. I was young and dumb, and I had no life skills, to be honest.
When you say young and dumb, was it the fact that you were successful very quickly at a young age, and that maybe sort of, as you say, you're a bit naive to the world because of it?
For now, I look back, I probably wish, I'm glad it did happen, but I wish it didn't happen so fast. I went from being a 15-year-old kid who no one knew to the most famous sports person in New Zealand and then throughout the world. And
I think you knocked off Michael Campbell, who won a major in golf, and you knocked him over for Sportsman of the Year 1 year, didn't you?
Yeah, I went to the first sports awards and I got male sportsman, sports person, junior sports person, and I cleaned up Michael Campbell, which was, but to me then, I didn't mean anything. I was just happy riding and enjoying as it, the life and the things that came with it, and I'll be honest, it probably went to my head.
Now, you seem to be really well settled here now. You're riding, do a lot of, got a great relationship with Nigel Blackiston, the Pom and the Kiwi. How'd that unfold?
I rode a couple of winners for Nigel 7 years ago when I was here, and I've since came back, and a good mate of mine, Sean Buckley, asked me to go to Brisbane and ride his horse, which I did. And at that point, my then fiance, Simone, now married, so now we're married, we were sort of going to settle in Brisbane, and Sean said to me, why don't you come back to Melbourne and give it another crack? And he goes, I'll let you ride all my horses if you want. And Simone and I talked about it, and we jumped at the chance. And I got here, and Nigel had no stable rider. And he just said, would you like to be riding for me? And I said, yeah. So I started riding all his horses. And he's an amazing trainer, and we work well together, which is a good thing.
And not that he's got any cap horses, but he's certainly got a lot of promising young horses, hasn't he? Doesn't seem to have a big stable.
He doesn't, mate. I think he can only fit 18 or 20 horses in his barn at Flemington there. And, his horses always go to the races looking like show condition. And if they generally give 110%, if they go no good, there's obviously a reason.
No, I noticed that you rode the successful youngster in Darcy Brahma. He was a very, very good horse, and you won a couple of group ones on him?
Yeah, he was a really good horse.
Is he the best horse you've ridden?
Definitely not.
No?
Definitely not.
Who's the best horse you've ridden?
The best horse I've ever ridden, here in Australia you might not know, she was a little filly trained by Graham Rogerson. She would have been 15 hands high and biggest heart. You could win from front, you could go from the back, you can sit wide, she'd go heavy tracks, firm tracks, stay, sprint. Her name was Tattletale.
You also rode that, it was a Tit for Tat, that was a good horse that you rode as well.
Yeah, he was a good sprinter. I came to Australia and rode him a few times. He didn't really perform too good over here, but I think I pushed Sunline in the Mudgeway Partsfield Stakes at Hastings. You know, I was happy that I was nearly going to... She only got me on the line, but I guarantee I would have been booed off course.
Yeah, she was a handy mare. Now, you mentioned earlier on about pig hunting. Was that something that you all did at a young age? Of course, you had that terrible accident where the pig landed on you, but was that just part of growing up, was it, pig hunting?
Yeah, I suppose my cousins were more into it than I was. They got me into it, and I didn't do it for years, and I started doing it again probably 2005 or something. And unfortunately, I had an accident doing it, and that's the rest is history.
I don't remember much about it, because you actually spent the night in the bush, didn't you, in the ravine, because you couldn't get out.
Yeah, something that happened, and you know, I've talked that much about it now, I should remember it, but I only remember slight flashbacks. I remember a little flashes about it, but apart from that, nothing.
You're enjoying your time in Australia now? I mean, you seem to be really well settled, getting good rides. You know, there's a big feature race just around the corner, I reckon.
I hope so. I'm really enjoying it here. People are great. Owners and trainers are amazing to ride for. The jockeys over here are really, really cool. My wife and I, you know, we've never been happier, and things are ticking along pretty well. And I suppose the key to my success is, you know, I'm mad enough to say it, they say behind every man there is a great woman, and I've got one.
Well done. I noticed I was at Cranman the other day, Cranman Cup Day, and I saw you in the jockey's room there. Fairly handy ink work, Michael. Now, Aris Spiteri reckons he's got the best in the jockey's room. He reckons he's got everybody covered. But you get some pretty decent work there yourself.
Yeah, he loves to skite about it. I'm not that type of bloke, but yeah, I've my whole back's covered, my chest, my whole right arm, my left arm. Got my kids' names on my left arm, which is the English part of them. And then the Māori side, which we don't actually call it tattoos or ink, it's called tāmoko.
Because it is, I mean, you're Māori extraction, and that's, I mean, I think, I'm not saying they invented tattooing, but they're certainly, it's part of the culture, isn't it?
It is, most definitely, and you know, I don't regret getting it.
What's the main, actually? What's the significance of tattooing?
Well, anyone sees it, it just looks like lines and shapes and so forth, but each line has a special meaning. Where you came from, where your parents came from, how your tribe got to New Zealand, what part of New Zealand I'm from. There's a lot. My great grandmother, she's all over my back. These shapes that are actually the shape of a heart, which is my two kids, my grandmother, my mother, my father. There's meaning everywhere all over me. So,
Michael, I just want to see how settled you are in Australia. Bledisloe Cup, Wallabies v the Kiwis, All Blacks, who are you barracking for?
Definitely the All Blacks, mate. Silly question. I don't even think I'll need to watch the game. I'll just go to bed and know that I'm going to wake up and we've won.
Well, you nearly got beaten in the most recent one. I know it was Brisbane, I know it was a dead rubber, but it did give the Wallaby supporters some hope.
We were only making you think we're weak when we're actually strong. Look out next game.
I think that might be enough of Michael Walker. Thanks for joining us, Nick. Best of luck in the future.
Cheers. Thank you very much. Really appreciate it.